Eric Dolph covering. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Very troubling news coming out of South Korea. We're finding this on the New York Times. They've actually published an article speaking about U.S. evacuation drills in South Korea, heightened fears of military action. This is while the South Korean president is still calling for a diplomatic solution to the crisis with North Korea. The South Korean president doesn't want a military option, but it seems like that the U.S. military deep state here in the U.S. here is just bound and determined they're going to have that military confrontation with North Korea one way or the other. Now, granted, again, we realize that Kim Jong-un, certainly a dictator that has totally lost control of how to respond diplomatically himself. He's not willing to back down. President Trump is not willing to back down. And so now we're facing a very serious dilemma. Now, the U.S. military is claiming that this is part of a normal drill, part of normal exercises that have gone on for many years, that they have always practiced this type of drill where they're moving the non-combatant personnel out in a mass evacuation. But it just seems to be a little bit odd, a little bit ironic that at this time, when the tensions between North Korea and the United States are at an all-time high, that he is willing to do these type drills, or that the U.S. military is willing to do this type drills at this time. Now, granted, it would be a good idea to practice moving out all non-essential combatant personnel out of the area there if they are truly planning on a war with North Korea. But it also kind of heightens the tensions that are already on edge as it is. Now, also, another issue I wanted to share with you, Yonhap News is showing this particular image here on the screen here behind me, shows President Trump and his visit that is coming up very soon to South Korea. And of course, there has been talk about him going to the demilitarized zone there. And I think that is pretty doggone nuts, if you ask me. President Trump certainly, as much as he has been bold in his statements, speaking about destroying North Korea, totally wiping the country off the map, fire and fury, and then for the president of the United States to visit South Korea and then go to the demilitarized zone with North and South Korea, that, to me, just definitely is not the smartest thing in the world that could be happening. It's not good for the safety of the president, in my opinion. I really think that it would be better that president, as he goes to Japan, that he skips over South Korea, goes straight into China. That would be the wiser decision. Not that North Korea would probably do anything, but it's still a risky proposition for the president of the United States to make that type of call, in my estimation anyway. Also, we know that the Iraqi military has moved into the newly found Kurdistan, as they have called themselves in their own self-proclaimed referendum. The Kurdish people in the western part of Iraq have declared their autonomy there. The Iraqi military saying that they would not accept this. They have moved the military in. All parties have been asking both sides to use some caution here. But it doesn't look like it's going to go that well as far as the caution there. The United States, of course, has not been openly supported of a Kurdistan there, but yet the U.S. has backed the Kurdish people very much militarily, especially in eastern Syria, and trying to take over all the oil-rich areas there of eastern Syria, east of the Euphrates River. In that case, I think the U.S. is probably behind what is going on even in as far as Iraq and western Iraq there. Why? Because it is definitely got about a third of the oil revenues of Iraq, from what I've been able to gather thus far in some of the news media that I've been looking at on this. So once again, it's to benefit the United States. So the Kurdish people have been relying on the U.S. to give them weapons to be able to defeat ISIS, and as well to help fight for autonomy in this region. Israel has already recognized or at least have accepted what the Kurds are doing inside their country. But at the same time, it's just more destabilization. You know, it's kind of interesting. It's like this is just spreading like wildfire. Louis Farrakhan even mentioned in a speech publicly just recently, in the last couple of days here, about that the black people should have their own state within the United States, or if not here, some other place in the world. He likened the fact that the U.S. is supporting Israel financially and they have their own state there. He said that the black population should have their own state as well. I just can't help but wonder, what in the world is going on? Spain, same situation over there. The Catalina, the people there trying to declare their own independence. What's happening in the world? All these different breakups of nations. Where is there a place where nobody lives at that you could actually declare another nation for someone else to begin with? Even if Louis Farrakhan could get his dream worked out, where would you do it? That somebody else wouldn't have to be driven out in order to appease this type of a situation. It's just, you know, things are just nuts, friend. Absolutely nuts. Anyway, I'm Stephen Benoon. Trust this is a blessing to you this evening. We've actually, the third time we recorded this already, I'm kind of in a rush now because third time we recorded, we're having some difficulties here, electronic difficulties here in the studio this evening. Anyway, blessings to you. God bless you. And we'll be talking to you again tomorrow. Hopefully, we'll be adding another teaching tomorrow on Danoon Institute. Definitely subscribe to Danoon Institute because they won't be appearing here on Israeli News Live. Erev Tov.